Now I'm a booth of Ankush Enterprises. They are bringing beautiful trends in India, because when we talk about ice cream, storage is a big problem. If you don't have a storage, if you don't have right transportation for the ice cream, it will not reach to your home. They have some solutions for anti-melting ice creams. Now let me go to them and ask. We have the managing director of the company with us. Can you tell us what is the special thing you are displaying this time at your booth for the Ice Cream Expo?
So basically we are a food ingredient distributor based out of Mumbai, and we are representing many foreign companies for their ingredients in various segment of the business. So for this particular display, we have got one starch, potato starch, which is helping towards the process of slow melting of the ice cream, and which is unique of its kind. Like, even we keep it at room temperature for 30 minutes and the ice cream will not melt. So that is not available in India, and which we are promoting. So I think this is one of the innovation, and which is going to be even displayed in the FI India in the innovation zone. So that is what we are doing.
Okay. Do you see that you have the solution, right solution for the Indian market, and they will accept these kind of changes what you are bringing from developed markets?
This is the right kind of product what we are bringing in for the Indian market, because Indian market, the summers are very hot. So the melting of the ice cream is one of the biggest challenge what the industry is facing, and what we are offering is a clean label starch, so it doesn't have any E number also, so there should be no issues on that. It is the right solution for the industry.
Can I see that ice cream?
Sure.
So this is the thing you are talking about. If I'm keeping this ice cream for half an hour or 40 minutes, this is not going to melt.
Right. This is not going to melt.
Can you show this? This is a new trend. Suppose you are having ice cream at your dinner table, keeping it before eating the dinner, and eating it after as a dessert after dinner, it will remain same. So this is something which is very innovative, and I believe that this is going to get a very good response from the Indian manufacturers. So what is the experience? You explained you met many manufacturers today and yesterday. So what is their take on this?
So basically, first and foremost, people were not able to digest that this kind of product can come, and all the big people had come over here yesterday, and they were all very much impressed. And everybody has said that they want to try the product. And for the fact that this is already implemented and being used by one big manufacturer in India, and this trend has to catch up. This trend has to catch up. Just think of it like that. You open up your party pack, and you are serving it to all the guests, and it starts melting. But if it doesn't melt for 30 minutes, 40 minutes, you can do a wonderful thing. So it's a very good product.
Right. So now let me go back to your stall and talk to this beautiful lady from Turkey, right?
Yes.
Yeah, I remember. Yeah. So how do you see this show and people coming from different brands of ice creams to your booth and understanding what you are serving? So how do you see this show shaping?
This was what we were talking amongst us. You know, we compared this to the other exhibitions that we have been in the last 1 year, and this is really a qualified one, because really the sector leaders and the specific people are visiting our booth, and it is really qualified meetings, really qualified people are coming, so we are really enjoying this show.
Do you see?
It is very to the point, and it is very relevant to the market.
Do you see Indian market is at a point where it will go further and grow in leaps and bounds for the global trends bringing in India?
Of course, we always think that India is not really other than the other markets. It really have the potential to grow bigger, and it's already very big in our perception.
Thank you so much.
It's a valuable market.
Thank you.
Thank you
so much. So see, companies from all over the world visiting, displaying, showing their strength, what they are having for the Indian ice cream industry. Yeah. I'll come back. Yeah. So we have another company which is very good in packaging. They are the people who are innovating beautiful packagings. I would show you their display things. See how the boxes are kept. these are the, you know, this is a beautiful, you know, if I see this kind of a box, it is a very tempting box. See, who will not want ice cream if it is kept inside? You know, they are very attractive packagings. You see, there is one more packaging over here. This is called Creamy Cool, some Creamy Cool brand, and they are using beautiful packaging. So I would ask you how the response is to your product, because now packaging trends are changing, now demands are different. They are not at all the time kept in paper. We have now these kind of solutions. So how the response is to your company?
Yeah, it's very encouraging, and we have been a regular presenter in this Ice Cream Expo since last 4 years. And it has been very much encouraging and very much helping our business to grow. And of course, the trend is changing, and the Indian ice cream industry is totally moving towards a great jump in terms of volume. And definitely people are towards getting the product in very attractive and very clean containers. And so this change is definitely going to help the ice cream industry, as well as the consumers who will get their product in the best containers, packing containers.
Packaging is a very important aspect. It attracts everybody towards itself, because now if we go in any mall or any shopping complex, there are hardly selling people over there. Product itself says pick me up. If they are keeping every one guy for each brand or each section, they won't be able to sustain. So packaging plays a very important role in that. How your companies take on that?
Yeah, because see, now you see, when if you compare 15 years back, there were very few people going abroad. But now the trend has totally changed, that more and more people are going to European countries from India, and they have a great exposure about how things are being done in European countries. So the same thing, now we have to match up to those levels, so that our people also get the same kind of products in best packaging method, you know. So that exposure to people, are even when once they come back to India, they definitely look for the same kind of items or products to be packed in the same kind of packaging stuffs, you know. So that kind of a change is definitely helping India to grow. And in ice cream, which is a very fast growing area in the food industry, this is very much necessary, and of course this exhibition is a very great platform for people like us too.
Thank you so much. So see how the people are happy at their booths. They are getting good visitors, good number of people coming in and understanding what they are serving. Thank you so much. So now we are at the stall of Prigel. Prigel is called, it's a very old company from Italy, which provides a lot of good ingredients to the ice cream industry. Now we are going into this company's booth, and you see a lot of people, a lot of inquiries for them. So can I talk to Bobby? Can you come and join us for a minute? Can you tell us what you are serving to the ice cream industry today at your booth in this show?
Actually, Prigel is an international company. It's an Italian company which is very well known around the world. Places like US, Australia, Middle East and all, 70% market share is Prigel's. So we introduced Prigel in India for the last 5 years, and we show people how to make ice creams and gelatos using our Prigel ingredients, at the same time using our machinery, which is Ice Cream Expo-IICE. And actually, I would love our chef to give you a little explanation about the machinery, and then the Prigel team itself, they can talk more about Prigel.
Yeah. And can you come this side with the chef? So now see, they are making something very wonderful, very beautiful at their booth. And they are making, this is some kind of a sorbet. This is sorbet?
This is strawberry and raspberry palette.
Okay, it's a strawberry crush, I would rather say, with the chocolate. Can you tell us about this product?
This is a chocolate namelaka. Namelaka is a Japanese mousse made. Namelaka in Japanese means super smooth and soft. So this is a different kind of mousse, okay? Made with a special technique that we are able to make with this kind of machine. Our machine is a multifunctional machine for pastry, gelato and gastronomy. We are able to do whatever we want in between minus 35 and 105 degrees. So all the product that you need to cook or freeze, you can make with this machine. It's a super controlled process, super safe, and the fastest process on the market. So I can make a chocolate mousse in 15 minutes without having the problem to stay there mixing or whatever, because the machine will do everything by itself and everything is controlled. How I mix everything, how I cook everything, the final temperature, the freezing process, everything. So at the end I have a product that is made by the machine with my technique, and the machine works with me. So it's like a colleague for me in my laboratory, okay?
So you see this solution is good for the places where quick ice cream or quick pastries are required, like restaurants or display counters?
Exactly, our main customers are big hotels, caterings, big pastry shops that make gelato as well. So it's not a gelato machine, it is a multifunctional. So if I want to make a huge range of products, I can make them, and I can use this machine 24 hours per day, because I can start in the morning making custard cream for the breakfast, then I can make bolognese sauce for the afternoon or the lunch, then I can make a dessert for the night, or a granita or an Italian gelato. I can make the whole kind of product that you can serve in a kitchen or in a wedding or whatever, you can make with this machine.
Yeah. So now let me talk to the Brazil team. They are participating with this show from the last 6 years, I believe, and every time they are getting very good response, I believe. How is the show's response to you this time?
We'll leave it to Catherine.
Good morning. So the response is very good. As every time I have to say, we're always pleased to be here, because India is a very good market, and let's say like gelato fans are growing every year. So do you know who's Prigel? What is Prigel?
Prigel
is okay. Prigel, it's an historical company founded in Italy more than 50 years ago, and our mission is just to deliver the best gelato everywhere in the world. We have branches in many countries. We have amazing partners in other countries, and so you know that gelato together with pizza and pasta and cafe, it's really part of our tradition. So we really want our customers to try only the best. So you see we have some toppings here, okay. And the Prigel, it's just about natural ingredients. Few is a steps stabilizer, so something like this is a base. The base is the heart, the core of every gelato, okay? And then we let our customers, we give the know-how, we give the support, we give the other ingredients that you can use to play and create your own recipe.
Okay. As you said, Indian lovers of gelatos in India are growing. But how they are picking up, how this market is developing, not only in India, but in other parts of the world where they are more having ice creams than gelatos. So you see good future for gelatos in the other parts?
Yes, because actually, yeah, of course, the ice cream, it's popular, it's cheap, it's everywhere. But people now, you know, in food business in general, they're going toward a more artisan, natural direction, and this is gelato. So we are going back to the tradition. Even, you know, young generation from every country, they travel a lot, they have Instagram, they are foodies, they want to experience only the best. So I see, not only in India, but everywhere in the world, a very positive trend for everything that is made with heart and good quality.
Okay. Bobby, can you once and for all, can you tell us what is gelato and what is ice cream? Still there is a lot of confusion among the consumer's mind, so maybe they can click on this interview and come know what is the difference between.
See, the main difference technically in Italian, ice cream is called gelato. But when it comes to technical details, ice cream has much more air into it. They infuse, it could be from 80 to 120% of air. So it's much more fluffier, and the ingredients which go into an ice cream, unlike gelato. Gelato is much more natural ingredients. It has less sugar, less fat. So it's much more healthier when it comes to that. And in gelato, the air is like 25 to 30%. So it's much more flavorful, I would say. So these are the basic differences which a layman would understand these. But in general, gelato is picking up all over the world. In India, there was little misconception when it came to gelato. People started thinking there's gelatin in that, which is technically not true. There's no gelatin in gelato. That was a big misconception which a lot of people had. When you say pre-gel, they think, oh, there is, it's kind of some gel. No, it's a company name. And gelato itself, there's no gelatin. That we are trying to put across to people, and slow by slow, it's people are learning about it. Sooner or later, they will. Again.
There are many, there's a whole section of Indians who are going to the global places, all over, moving around and understanding the trends over there and coming back to the country. You see this section is growing and they are easily accepting these things when it is available next to their home.
Yes, they are, because the younger generation nowadays, they are well-versed, they travel and they know stuff. I mean, not like unlike before. Now people are traveling. There's an younger generation coming up and I think India is the place where we have a lot of young crowd. So they are ready to experiment, they're ready to try, they are ready to do a lot of new things. So that's where we see the market growing. And if instead of traveling and having a gelato somewhere else in some other country, if they have it in their hometown, yes, they would love to enjoy it more than once or twice a year. That's what it is.
Thank you, Bobby. Thanks. So we can understand what is the difference between gelato and ice cream and how gelatos are made. What are the efforts behind this, ingredients, machineries and efforts of these people who are running and mostly on the tour with their bag and with the samples, people coming from all over the world, all across the continents, from Italy, and telling us eat gelatos, eat healthier ice creams because they are more fresh and made easily. Thank you so much.
Last thing, it's not only gelato guys who use pre-gel, who use our ingredients. It's ice cream industry also for flavoring, because pre-gel itself is natural ingredients. So there are ice cream industries, there are pastry shops, there are baking, because most of our flavors are bake stable. So there are all different kinds of people, different kinds of industry who use them, not only gelato guys. So in India, for our sales, we have more ice cream guys also buying our ingredients than only the gelato guys. For gelato guys, we have pin to craft from bases till the flavors and till the toppings. For ice cream guys, they might end up only using our flavors or only our bases. That's how it is.
Premium, maybe premium line of ice cream.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yeah, let's catch up. Yeah, thank you. Nice meeting you. So now I'm at a booth where there are very good kind of packagings are on display. Some paper packaging, cups, glasses, straws, you know, some very trendy things, because now plastic is on a high alert. So if this is a paper straw, you can see they have paper bags, we have paper all over this booth, and some very nice solutions for bulk ice creams. I can see nice have more tumbler over here where good amount of ice cream can be consumed. Can you tell us about what are the products you are offering and what is the specialty in your stall?
Sir, nowadays we are giving indoor bar ice paper for ice cream segment. So inside, if nowadays everyone is asking biodegradable. If plastic goes banned, so without poly coating, we are promoting some specific paper. This is like a PLA coating, polylactic acid cups and biodegradable cup. In that, they are using some chemical treatment. So which is Mitsui company, German. They are providing FDA and food grade certificates and all. Also, we are provide very soon. We will provide you CPET certifications at all. So these are the products very specialized in future product. So you can see different sizes and everything.
How is the response to your new trends? What you are displaying here? Because everybody who is coming, they are all from the food industry or the ice cream industry, or the dairy industry people. So how the response is coming to your booth and your products?
Yeah, well, I noticed that everyone is very interested to support plastic ban on all. So now they are looking for biodegradable product. So they don't mind to spend much money comparing to plastic and paper. Paper is little expensive. Yeah. So, but people are ready to face that and they are supporting very well. So I hope definitely plastic will ban and it will come biodegradable days.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Yeah.
So now we are at a booth where we are again having wonderful flavors being displayed over here. Kept in a beautiful way, we have wonderful flavors. See the packaging of this, and these are the flavors somebody will try and make good ice creams. We have, you know, these flavors coming from all the way from Europe. Hi Gagan, how are you? Can we talk for a minute? What is the specialty you are offering this time at your booth in the Ice Cream Expo?
Basically, these are the Italian ingredients. They are mostly the natural flavors for gelato and ice cream manufacturers. Mm-hmm. So they are more close to nature, mm-hmm. all authentic, different than the regular ice cream products. So this is the USP of these products.
You're participating first time in this show. We met last time somewhere in Delhi. How's the experience so far? What is your feel about this show?
Experience has been very, very wonderful, I would say. It has been a great opportunity to be present here and know actually what's going on in the industry, where the industry is moving and where we are and how we can move ahead in looking forward, and definitely looking forward for next year participation too.
Yeah. So how's the response to your product? Basically, ultimately it is all when the product sells and goes into the deeper parts of the industry.
You see, the response is very, very, I would say, very encouraging for us, especially as we are here for the first time and we just launched this product in last September. So being very new, the opportunities are huge for people like us, and it's a very good platform to be here. I think so.
Thank you. Thanks for your participation. I hope your participation grows and your stall size bigger. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. From the bottom of my heart, I would like to thank every one of you, especially the members, manufacturers of ice cream industry, ice cream products, and all the exhibitors, all the visitors who have come from Jammu, from South India, from Calcutta, from Guwahati, from Rajasthan, Maharashtra, even deeper places in these states, and many more states from Orissa and from places. So I'm very, very thankful to each one of you, my exhibitors who have displayed wonderful products, wonderful technologies, machineries, lot of pain, lot of, you know, when you bring a big machine from China or from Europe or from different parts of the country, from Pune or Gurgaon, it takes a lot of energy, a lot of time. So thank you all. We know that it's gonna be a long night for us because all the wrap-ups are going on now. So this is a big thanks from my side. Next year, those who have missed this time and those who have attended this time, next year we are going to meet in Hyderabad. So let's see how good that show would be. We are trying to make it much bigger and better because that's going to be our 10th edition. So 10th edition will be something new. We are trying to make some arrangements from where we will have more international participation from neighboring countries and from developed world where the ice cream is being consumed in a big way. So thanks all once again, signing off from for now. Little tired but not broken. Thank you so much.